how is the system of science going to improve in 2024 so that it can speed up and make all of our lives better sooner? Hello, it's Dr. Mike Morrison with Better Science, where we look at ways to speed up the scientific system through better design. People usually think that science is discovering as fast as it can, and it's not, because scientists are stuck with these old tools that slow them down. So let's see how each of those tools will improve in 2024. Science flows through basically three mediums: scientific articles, posters, and presentations, and we're gonna see improvements to each of those in 2024. And I know that because, as they say, the best way to predict the future is to create it. And I'm part of teams that are working to improve scientific articles, posters, and presentations. So I'm drawing from work we're doing and also from the work going on in communities around me in MetaScience. First, scientific articles. In 2024, I think we're finally going to start moving away from publishing science in PDF and Word files and towards publishing articles as computational articles. Articles are the main way that science is published, and they've grown pretty detached from how science is produced and consumed these days. In the 1800s, journals mailed scientific articles to scientists as long-form pieces of physical paper, which was perfect because reading long-form pieces of paper is how everybody read everything in the 1800s. And then in the 1990s, we moved to reading things online on our desktop computers, and we expected content to get a lot more visual and shorter and more skimmable, and also have links to other content. And scientific publishing compensated by moving their long-form pieces of paper into digital long-form pieces of paper in PDF files, and then throwing up paywalls in front of them. Then in the 2010s, we got iPhones, the mobile phone revolution hit, and we got used to things that were much, much more skimmable, much more bite-sized, and even more interactive. And scientists started using tools like Jupyter Notebooks to communicate in new, interactive ways. And scientific publishing stayed in long-form PDF files. Now in 2024, with AI tools like the Elicit search engine and like the Scholar AI plugin for ChatGPT, we're consuming science more like summaries across papers, or by extracting just the piece of information we're looking for from a bunch of papers at once with Elicit. And if we do decide to read an article in depth for a full 2 or 3 minutes these days, we expect it to be really engaging, really skimmable, and really interactive and really visual. And a paywalled, long-form, 30-page PDF is the opposite of interactive and engaging. They say the average scientific article is read by about 8 people. We're gonna see the average views on a scientific article go down even more because you're gonna spend less time reading an actual article and more time extracting information from them. Leaving us in a situation where after a scientist completes a study, they spend an extra year or two preparing that study to be published in a journal in a format that's unusable and that nobody reads and that pretends like we're not all just using AI and phones now. I think 2024 is going to be kind of a breaking point for scientific publishing, and we're going to finally move towards a format for scientific articles that is easier for AI tools to digest, that's more engaging when you actually want to read it, and that includes all of the data and figures and analysis to make it easier and faster for scientists to build on each other's work and reproduce it. Computational articles do all of these things, which is why you're going to see them a lot more in 2024, and you're going to hear me saying computational articles over and over again the whole year. The basic idea behind a computational article is that scientists stop writing their papers so much in Word and start using tools like Jupyter with MyST or R with Quarto to get their story and their analysis and their data all in one place. This kind of empowers the scientists themselves to create versions of their article that are already beautiful and interactive and really super engaging and include all of their data and figures. Which is especially true with articles written with MyST Markdown in Jupyter, because you can attach a bunch of Jupyter notebooks to your article as like kind of supplementary analysis if you want to, and then people can reproduce those. I also have a short video out showing how extremely machine-friendly these computational articles are. It's a lot easier for AI tools and for search engines to extract information accurately from a computational article than it is from a PDF file. And people working on AI teams for science don't have to waste so much time parsing PDFs. They can just read it accurately from the first time and focus on interpreting. And compared to the traditional Microsoft Word file approach of scientific publishing, these computational articles are also a lot easier and faster to publish for the publisher. One of the reasons for that is because computational articles can be automatically typeset. Computational articles can reduce the amount of time it takes to typeset a scientific article from 3 weeks or more down to minutes or seconds. Just this aspect of computational articles means that if the cure for cancer is published as a computational article, it'll come out 3 weeks sooner. It's even easier for publishers and software developers to create better, more efficient peer review tools for these computational articles, and I've got a whole video on that if you're interested. So to sum up scientific articles, in 2024, you're going to see a lot more publishers start to accept computational articles instead of Word files and PDFs, and you're going to see a lot more tutorials showing you how you can start creating computational articles for your own science. Now, trends for scientific posters in 2024. Like everything else in science, posters are something that haven't changed in 30 years. Now, posters is something I've had a lot of experience with. Some of you know me as the guy who created that cartoon about scientific posters that went viral a few years ago and had, I think, a significant impact on the way posters are designed in science. And I spent the last 4 years doing research and trying to improve scientific posters. The logic is basically that if you have an hour to read two scientific posters, then the traditional wall of text poster is fine. But you don't have an hour to read two posters. Scientists have an hour to read 100 posters. So reading 100 walls of text is impossible. So what scientists end up doing is they just sort of pick a couple posters and then ask the presenter to explain them all because they can't read them. And then they completely miss the 98 other insights from their field that they didn't have time to see. So what I suggested is that we design scientific posters more like posters. More like a billboard, so that scientists can walk into a room of 100 posters and learn something from all of them. You could learn from 100 posters in an hour instead of two, which could make poster sessions a lot more engaging and a lot less fatiguing, and give the scientists walking through a more comprehensive update on what's going on in their field in the same amount of time. Now in 2024, the first pilot studies on BetterPoster have been published, and I'm going to link them in the description. To sum it all up for you, at first, people basically liked version 1 BetterPoster more than the traditional poster, but they wanted more methods shown on it. So we added a big key figure in the middle, and that seemed to help a lot. This sort of version 1.5 BetterPoster with the big key figure and the big takeaway sentence in the middle was rated as the most accessible poster design for conference attendees with accessibility needs. That's more accessible than infographics, traditional posters. And since accessibility and usability are the same thing, it's probably safe to infer that the design rated the most accessible is also the most usable, and BetterPoster 1.5 was rated the most accessible. In all BetterPoster layouts, the first one, the 1.5, the Generation 2 ones that came out in 2020, all of those seem to perform better in simulated eye tracking, which means they're less cluttered and they help your eye orient to what's on the poster much, much faster, which was on purpose. But I think the big trend in 2024 for posters is that we're going to get away from this whole like better poster versus traditional kind of debate and start focusing on incorporating the features about specific poster designs that work really well. And I think the research on posters generally supports the idea that really big key figures and big takeaway statements are good for accessibility and usability. So I think in 2024, we'll see bigger figures and more clear takeaways on posters. And personally, I really like the trend of people moving their authors to the bottom of the poster to leave more room for the takeaway statement at the top to kind of like communicate. That was one of the first changes I made to my posters in grad school to improve them, was decluttering the message at the top by taking the authors to the bottom. So the big trend in posters in 2024 is going to be bigger figures, more key takeaways, and maybe moving the authors to the bottom. Now, 2024 trends for scientific presentations. First, of course, I think AI is going to help scientific presentations be better and worse. On the one hand, the good news is that AI will help you create more visual presentations. So scientists that didn't have the graphic design and illustration skills before are now going to be able to generate those things much more easily instead of using bullet points. But the bad news is they can generate the bullet points too, so you're going to see even more stale presentations in some rooms. But I think the big trend for 2024 in scientific presentations is going to be improving the accessibility of presentations. We did a study of accessibility of conference presentations, and there are some challenges with it. So you can imagine that like a lot of people don't just have one disability. You can have, you know, multiple disabilities kind of interacting, and you can have sort of competing forces between different disabilities. So imagine someone with a visual impairment, they want a lot of narration from the speaker and they want really, really big images on the slides. But someone with an audio impairment wants the opposite. You know, they can't even hear the speaker. They want to be able to have some text on slides to focus on that and be able to understand what's happening. And then someone with a processing disorder wants less of that text on the slide. So there's a lot of sort of tensions between the different accessibility needs. But the number one requested accessibility accommodation in our study was actually being able to access scientific presentations from home. Because then if you have a visual impairment, you can blow it up and zoom in. If you have a hearing impairment, you can switch on the closed captions. And if you have a processing disorder like severe ADHD or something, you can rewind or slow it down, which is also helpful for everyone, as again, an accessible presentation is a usable presentation. The problem with this request to be able to access scientific presentations from home is that recording every scientific conference talk can be really, really expensive to do professionally. And that's why conferences have been resistant. They're releasing their intellectual property, but they get more branding out of it. And it's really expensive to set up these recording apparatuses in all the conference rooms. And then to manage the videos afterwards. That's kind of a huge task to ask conferences to do, even if it is more accessible. But I think in 2024, we're gonna start to see conferences figure this out somehow and develop kind of new systems for getting every conference talk recorded and posted online for people to view at home, even if it's not super polished. Having a designated recorder in the audience with an iPhone is still better than no recording. And I think conferences are gonna be motivated to figure this out. One, for branding reasons, you can get more promotion for your conference, but also, like, accessibility is really important in science. We want every scientist to be able to see every talk. That, it's also like there's a financial disparity in conferences where a lot of people can't afford to attend the conference and then they just miss that knowledge. Like, there's this huge problem here that's really slowing down progress on a lot of this stuff. So to sum up our better science trends for 2024, for scientific articles, we're going to see scientists publish more computational articles instead of Word files. And those computational articles are going to be more engaging, easier and faster to publish, and more reproducible. For scientific posters, you're going to see bigger figures and more big takeaway statements, which is going to help you learn from more posters in the room instead of just two. And scientific presentations are going to start to become more available online than they have been in the past, making them more accessible to scientists with accessibility needs and more impactful too. And all of this will help science spread further and faster, and help scientists build on each other's work more quickly. Here's a list of people and companies to follow who are innovating in each of the areas we've talked about. And I'm including the company I work for, Curvenote, on this list, unabashedly, because I really believe in the work we're doing to redesign the scientific article and help scientific publishers publish more modern article formats. Curvenote is a company founded by scientists for scientists, and it really shows in the way they run things, and I really love working there. And this video wouldn't exist without Curvenote giving me the time to make it for you. So thanks for watching, and remember that every system can be improved with better design, and when you improve science, it means saving a lot of people. Happy New Year.